And as we just heard, the major concerns raised at today's meeting were the problems of small business, particularly when it comes to loans and credit. Well, NewsHour correspondent Tom Bearden reports now on how that has played out for small businesses in Colorado.
This tiny house is the world headquarters of the Vedante Corporation in Boulder, Colorado. Barbara Cantor's business card says CEO and founder. She's also the marketing manager, chief accountant, and inventory manager. In short, a one-woman corporation. It wasn't always that way. A former California fashion designer and independent businesswoman, she moved to Colorado 2 years ago to do something new, manufacture and sell reflective armbands and dog leashes to help motorists spot pedestrians at night. At first, it went well. The products are popular on Amazon.com and in retail outlets. But then the recession hit, and her sources of capital began to dry up.
I started looking at bank funding, and boy, it's a nightmare out there, to be honest, at the moment. The banks just aren't loaning to small businesses, and I have an extremely high credit rating.
Unable to get a loan, she cut costs, gave up her office space, began to take deliveries at home, and to use her own car to haul products to an unheated storage unit 45 minutes away, where she stacks and tracks it all, even in the depths of a Colorado winter. Small business owners like Cantor seem to be the hardest hit as banks hold on to capital in the wake of the banking crisis last year.
Do you have any messages for me?
Don Childers is the head of the Colorado Bankers Association.
Lenders themselves have their own financial restrictions. We've suffered bigger loan losses than we're typically used to. That naturally depletes the capital of the bank, which means it basically can lend less in a community. Now, we happen to have record capital levels because we're so conservative. We've been stashing capital into the bank as fast as we can.
While banks say they need to hold on to more capital to prevent a future collapse, President Barack Obama is asking them to loosen up. That's why he invited bank executives to the White House today to discuss how they can better help small businesses looking for loans.
So it'll be 350.
Lee Prozenjak could have used that help not long ago. He's co-owner of the Cherry Creek Dance Studio near downtown Denver. Each week, some 1,800 students, ages 4 to 64, come here for lessons in ballet, jazz, hip-hop, and tap.
Heel forward, knee is straight.
The studio has been profitable for 16 years. Last summer, Prozenjak went shopping for a $1 million loan to expand to larger studio space. He says his business is so good that the Small Business Administration, a federal agency that guarantees small business loans from private banks, gave him a letter to show lenders that the SBA would guarantee 40% of the value of the loan. The banks were not impressed.
The national banks shut it down immediately. There was nothing, you know, nothing, not a chance there. The local banks at least sort of seemed to run it up the flagpole a bit. And to have them just sort of turn it down flatly without even really taking a look at the package was, you know, sort of a slap in the face.
Prozenjak got his new studio, but only because the real estate market was so bad that the building's owner agreed to carry the loan himself.
Now, is this one more reflective than...
Yeah.
Cantor and Prozenjak are just two examples of what Ken Coors calls the worst small business crisis in American history. Coors is a retired, longtime small businessman who volunteers with SCORE, the Service Corps of Retired Executives. The organization provides business advice to people like Cantor.
The banks are not making loans, of course, and they are reducing credit lines. They're making life miserable for good, solid companies that are in tough times. We're saving the banks. We're saving the car companies. We're saving the insurance companies. These little people under the radar, they're not political. They can't hire lobbyists. They're just there trying to do the best they can, and we're not helping them. We can, but we're not.
The $787 billion stimulus bill includes a number of programs designed to help small businesses get through the recession. Among them is the $255 million America's Recovery Capital Loan Program, or ARC. It offers $35,000 government-guaranteed loans to viable small businesses suffering immediate financial hardships. Karen Mills is the SBA administrator.
So far, we've done about 4,500 of them. They're in every state in the country, and they are right now about almost 1,000 banks making these loans.
that the government flatly designed a program with the best of intentions and a program that flatly does not work.
The Bankers Association's Childers says his members don't want to take part because the ARC qualification process is Byzantine.
I don't know of anybody within the SBA, in state government, any lenders that would defend that kind of bureaucratic nightmare that they put together. 32 pages of detail, whereas if I think a bank designed that, it would be a couple of pages of easy to understand things. There are not very many small businesses who actually qualify for ARC loans.
Barbara Cantor couldn't find a bank that would even talk to her about an ARC loan.
I think if you rode a GTS for a week, if you just borrowed one, you'd probably have to have one.
Colin Shattuck's banker wouldn't even take an application. Shattuck has been selling motor scooters at four stores in Colorado for more than 10 years. In 2008, Sportique scooters had a record year. What a difference a year makes. When gas prices dropped, sales cratered.
In 2008, we actually had local news outlet here to do a report on the scooter shortage in the United States. And now we're literally choking on inventory. It's beyond hard to stay open. It's virtually impossible. And we've had to reduce our staff levels much more dramatically than I ever have before. We've grown over the last 10 years, typically 20 to 25% per year. This is the first decline we've seen, and it's in excess of 60%.
So Shattuck turned to his longtime banker and asked about the ARC loan program.
My local banker, who's a friend of mine and an upstanding, nice guy, will look me right in the eye and tell me there's no credit. We've talked with numerous local banks. We've basically been told you don't have the assets to borrow against. And so we've looked into the ARC loan process through the SBA, which we're still working with Wells Fargo at this time. But early indications are we're going to be declined.
All three of these small business owners approached Wells Fargo and other banks, and all were turned down. Wells Fargo declined our request for an interview, saying they are the leader in small business lending. Childers says don't blame the banks. Blame conflicting signals from the government.
You've got the White House and the Congress and the media saying, go faster, lend more money. They've got their foot on the accelerator. They want the money loaned to businesses to kind of get us out of this recession. But we don't answer to any of those parties. Banks are regulated by a variety of bank regulatory agencies, and they have absolute control over a bank. And they are very conservative, and they say, no, you don't. We don't want you making those kinds of loans.
But Administrator Mills insists the ARC loan program, as well as other SBA loan programs, are a success.
We've gotten $16 billion in SBA guaranteed loans out into the hands of small business so far. So now, what do we do? Because there's still need for credit out there. So we've got programs that the President has asked Congress to continue our Recovery Act money. We're going to raise our limits.
In the meantime, Barbara Cantor got some bad news last week. J.P. Morgan Chase Bank slashed her line of credit by 90%.
Someone who's hardworking, who's ethical, who plays by the rules, always pays on time, the banks used to support. And no.
A lot of small business owners say they need help right now if they are to avoid closing their doors for good.